like you. I think you're a fake cop. The sound of your piss hitting the urinal, it sounds feminine. Mm-hmm. If we were in the wild, I would attack you. Even if you weren't in my food chain, I would go out of my way to attack you. If I were a lion and you were a tuna, I would swim out in the middle of the ocean and freaking eat you. And then I'd bang your tuna girlfriend.
A lion? Really? Lions don't like water. I mean, if you placed it near some fresh water source, that would make sense. But you're talking about an ocean, and I'm assuming this is off the coast of South Africa, a 20-foot wave going up against a full-grown 800-pound tuna. You lose that battle. You lose that battle 9 out of 10 times, my friend. And we ate lion, and we thought to ourselves, and we said, hey, lion tastes good. Let's get some more lion. We developed a system getting oxygen using the kelp apparatuses. Maybe not long, an hour, hour 45. Enough time to find out where you live and stalk you and your pride. You just got outmanned and outgunned. Is that a good way, Thoughtwood? Nope.
I'm Jesse's sister, Georgie. Now that I got your attention, let me introduce you to my brother, Jesse. Talking on a dream. How can I explain? Talking to myself. Will I see again? I'm totally in love with him. I have been from the day he was born. Nicole and I nicknamed Jesse Chicken Fliggle because his little legs were like chicken wings.
I'll never forget how emotional and incredible I felt holding him for the first time.
See, I had a really a tremendous opportunity with my grandson to be able to live in this house when he was 9 years old. He would, you know, sneak down while I was sleeping, throw water on me. We had a really good time, and he used to get me a little mad, though. I would chase him around the house.
He's got gorgeous hair.
When Jesse had his curls and I would walk in the house, Freddie would always make fun and say, Jesse, you and Mimi have the same hairstyle. Of course, things have changed now. Jesse's hair is short and straight, but when he was young, we definitely had the same hairstyle.
With my brother. If somebody tried to kiss me, maybe he would kick my butt.
Kick their butt?
No, kick my butt.
He would kick your butt.
He is an incredible child, an incredible grandson. He has warmth, he has empathy, he has intelligence, he has looks, he's great at sports, and honestly, he has it all.
He's creative, intelligent, a mensch, does the right thing.
A unique young man that has a tremendous mind. He's a grandson that you can be really proud of.
I think think he's athletic and smart and crazy sometimes.
And then I had the opportunity this year to take my grandson to the doubleheader that the Pirates play, where I found out that I wasn't really sitting with my 12-year-old grandson. I was sitting with sort of like another guy that I'm friends with. To be able to sit with a family member, let alone your grandson, and watch a doubleheader where the Pirates could beat the Cardinals was like a fantasy. And he's a friend's friend. He's a good boy.
Champagne player, yeah, my money insane player, yeah, I'm making it rain player, but I was just on a plane player, buying gear, flying here, it ain't what you heard, it's my time of year,
The bigger the field, the harder you ball, well, I'm throwing mine, cause my money long, the quicker you're here, the faster you go, that's why where I come from, the only thing we know is, the bigger the field, the harder you ball, well, I'm throwing mine, cause my money.
Jake, Zach, and Jesse grew up like brothers, but they're cousins, so we call them Brazins. Brazins.
I'm Jake.
I'm Zach.
And we're the Brazins.
We've been together literally since we've been in diapers.
Wait, you don't think they're gonna put the bathtub fix in, are they?
No.
The kids, he's totally insane. All of a sudden, he started working out. Now he can pump like 70 push-ups. Jesse's definitely a Rabner. He knows to talk his way out of anything. If there's a couple girls we want to walk up to, he's always the person to go to. He just always knows what to say.
He might be my little cousin, but I would want him on my team every time.
We remember all three of us having sleepovers just up in Jesse's room. Uncle and Aunt Nikki, they always come up and yell at us, and we try and stop. It's hard.
Saying whose head they should rip off.
Is that true?
It's very accurate.
We love you, dude.
So, when I was younger, Jesse would always cook for me and make me toast, and I thought it was like so cool that he knew how to use the toaster, so I thought it'd be a great idea if when I was games actress, he could come along and be my private cook. Obviously, I'm already on my way.
Jesse was ordering shrimp, and we go, and of course, Jesse knows how he wants his shrimp, and he told the waiter that he wanted it succulent, not tough, plump, a little bit of garlic, some lemon, and he looked at me and he said, Mimi, you know I have a sophisticated palate. And that was it. From that moment on, I'm thinking food critic, I'm thinking New York Times taking Adam Platt's place. Anything goes because Jesse knows food.
His favorite last time we had dinner was steak, twice baked potatoes, and he wanted a pecan ball.
Now I'm eating a smoked salmon bagel with red onion and cream cheese on everything bagel.
He was more than a connoisseur at the Hyde Park restaurant.
Hi, we're in New York, and we just stayed at Little Italy in Angelo's. I'm eating the ravioli and chicken parm. This ravioli, its sauce is like creamy tomato, and it has a couple flavors that I really enjoy. Like peppery and very creamy and kind of like red sauce. It's kind of like red sauce, but it's like you put a little bit more like just cream, and it's really thick, and it really just has that zip, you know? It's good food.
There's not one word that could describe Jesse.
Pizza.
Chill.
I was gonna say chill. He stole it. Now just think again. All the words in the world.
No, that was mine.
All
yeah.
the words in the world. Except there's not one word that could describe Jesse. Like all of the words in the world, except for the bad ones. He's just that dandy. Yeah. So at camp, we would have certain lights out times, and after lights out, Jesse's definitely not what's expected after lights out. He would not go to bed. Sleep was the last thing on his mind.
Here we go. That's him driving. Do you see that? It's him driving.
Rabbi Chuck, if you're listening, he just loves Hebrew school.
It's so annoying.
Jesse has always gone to Hebrew school happily.
I'm not even learning anything there.
I used to pick him up. He'd say, yeah, I learned a lot today.
It's you're gonna crap. See
I can tell he puts his whole heart into it.
I'm going to brunch with you guys.
And it really means a lot to him.
Well, don't you understand? I never learn anything there. You're just sending me there and spending money for no reason.
It's amazing to see how much he really is into the Hebrew religion.
He's getting it.
Stop it!
It seems like he really wants to do it. He possibly could be a rabbi.
I'm not going to Hebrew school.
And basketball. He's really funny, and I hear he sings a pretty good Haftorah.
Well, first of all, he's really good at sports, and he's so funny.
You did a great job. Mazel tov on your bar mitzvah. I know how much work it takes, and we're all really proud of you. You are going to have a great night. We love you, Jess.
Superstar Jesse right here.
Right.
We just met PJ, one of our true heroes. Someone who's made us laugh over the years, 60 seconds at a time, and now in movies.
You got to be an interviewer. You're incredible.
That was
new profession.
All right, there you go. Jesse,
hit it.
One thing to say.
Nice, Jesse. Give me five.
Put him on the board. Hausha Mazzoli. Got it. Championship.
Yo, happy birthday, Jay Easy. It's your boy, Young Khalifa, man. Just wishing you a real happy, great one from the Taylor Gang captain himself. And next time I'm in New York, make sure you hit me up, man. We're going to go to Angelo's, get some of them Half Moon raviolis. I heard them things is banging. TGLD, let's get it.
You're the coolest kid I know.
You're my main man.
Let's face it, dude. You're a bad motherfucker.
By the way, I'm Jesse's sister.
That's it. Don't say. And
stand by just a second. And go ahead.
Jesse, Zach, and Jake.
Take two.
Okay, wait, what are we saying? Jake, Jesse, and Zach. Jesse, Zach, and Jake.
What does Jesse have that you have?
Curly hair.
A penis.
Wait, I'm about to say. Stop. Guys, stop. This is all me cut off. My God.
I love the emotion. It's great, man. That's great. Perfect. Okay, start over.
Well, I got your attention. Sit back and relax and enjoy the show.
No, I'm going to introduce you to my brother Jesse. This is what happens. This is the last one.
Okay, ready?
Maybe some slow dance music.
Right.
Jesse's birthday sleepovers are legendary.
Are you gonna zoom in on them?
I don't get zoomed in. I'll tell you what.
Go ahead. Go.
What happens at sleepovers stays at sleepovers.
Good. And now the. Go on, Jack. 3, 2, 1.
Oh my God. All right, I got it.
Matt, you got this, remember? All right. You gotta give me serious. Ready?
There it is. Here, you can get him.
All right. Close home. Hello. Stay where you are.
We would always go to the beach and play Kadima. Cut.
So over the years, me and Jesse have gotten really close. We've gotten a lot of vacations together. I always make a massage. We get along really well. We also have a lot of stuff to talk about. We fight. We get along. It's really funny. We always make you laugh. We're really good cousins. We're really good guys. We're really tight. We're really good.
If peer pressure doesn't get to him, I think he might turn to the rabbinical school and go into the yeshiva. It seems like, you know, I could just picture him with a beard.
Face towards the camera a little more.
Sit.
That's it. Good, that'll work.
Have a great bar mitzvah, Jess. Love ya.